city and people. So we need to protect our system from short circuit, over voltage, either from lightning or surge voltage, then also to transient, abnormal transient, whether from direct heat and the non-direct heat of lightning. So, and of course, the difficult part of understanding for not, especially for electrical engineers, is the understanding of the grounding. So even the electrical code, this chapter 2.5, is a difficult problem to understand by our practitioner, the grounding. So in fact, I commended the Prisma for concentrating of this grounding because supporting the grounding system. Difficult to have this sell, no? To sell this product for the reason only few electrical practitioner understood this grounding, the importance of grounding, bonding, and lightning protection. Unless once they experience damage to equipment, like from the lightning, then they're just now aware and have to need the lightning protection. So especially the Philippines is one of also the country na frequent part na lightning strike, no? So like Australia, Singapore, and maybe Thailand, no? So we are in the every year we have frequency of lightning, especially during this time na rainy season. So maraming time we have so many lightning strike happening. That's why even Meralco have a lightning protections on your distribution system. No, you only see overhead static line, usually in the transmission. No? But since Metro Manila, or especially Quezon City, medyo located in high places, that's why we have so many overhead protection here. So first, we have to understand lightning. No? So how lightnings operate. So lightning theory. No? The next slide, of course, you can see with lightning coming downwards. Many people think that's only coming from a downward trend, no? The lightning. But it will show to you, there's also upward plus, not only downward. So this is the, so there's a positive concentrator here and negative here. It will create ionize the air. So there will be a downward plus of lightning. The same also if the ground is negative, and of course, then this concentration of positive, so from negative to positive, this portion will ionize. So if you're located in the high places, you are more likely strike by lightning. And also there's a downward, coming upwards, for lightning, no? So this one is upward, so taken by high-speed camera, no? So coming from concentration from the ground, going upward, no? So going upward, so magkakaroon tayo ng lightning stroke. Of course, you have to understand the principle of lightning for us, especially for safety, especially you are now in the farms, no? So usually, if you read that newspaper, accident, farmers getting hit by the lightning, no? For the reason, when there is lightning stroke, coming rains, they go to the tree or the rest house, and the rest house is located in the high places. No? So it means high places in the area. So if you are the highest place in that area, you were more likely hit by lightning, no? Because of this ionization of the air. So ang safety rules that what you are in the open field, and there is a lightning strike, and there is no one to go around. You just lie flat on the ground, so that you cannot be hit by lightning. So this one is our common mistake happening here, no? So if you notice, utility have service grounding electrode, the telephone line has its own telephone electrodes, cable TV has its own electrode, no? So different grounding electrodes are used for building and are not bonded together. So if they are not bonded, there is a potential difference between this grounding system, no? So hazard exists. So there's a voltage hazard that will exist. So if you touch these two, it may happen you may be electrocuted, no? Or suffer electric shock. So to solve this problem, you have to bond this grounding system, no? So there is a bonding. So if you bond it, what we call it now, equipotential. So if the system is equipotential, so the same voltage level, so no differential voltage. So it's safe now, no? So this should be understood in lightning protection, no? So this is written in the article 2.5, no? 5.7 of Philippine Electrical Code. Like this one, another one, non-compliance with Article 2.5311 of the Philippine Electrical Code, which prohibits using the same grounding electrodes for lightning rod and supply system. No? So that, for the proper way is to have this one have their own grounding electrode. No? So for this is for lightning protection, and this is for supply voltage also, no? So they shall have own grounding electrode. So this is the proper way. So there's a bonding requirement, no? This one only is a simplified method, no? This lightning grounding electrodes. So this is what required the proper installation of lightning protection system. Then this is Article 2.5, general requirement for grounding bonding. So we just have this discuss. No? Electrical system that are grounded shall be connected to earth in a manner that will limit the voltage exposed by lightning charge, or an intentional contact with higher voltage line, and that will stabilize the voltage to earth during normal operation. So this one, no? So supposed to be for proper protection, this line will not be directly hit by lightning. It will have in the upper place a overhead static wire, so that even the live voltage here will not be directly hit by lightning, no? So if you don't have this lightning rod here, so it might go to your system in the building or in the residential area. So your electrical equipment may be damaged, no? So the insulation protection. So if you have a lightning protections, then you protect them with insulation. So magmatch parallel yung lightning protection and insulation protection or insulation coordination. And also this one, no? So electrical system power supply are grounded to have limit high voltage imposed on the system, winding from induced lightning or line surge, no? Of course, this one also a normally non-current conductive material or equipment or forming for such equipment shall be connected to earth so as to limit the voltage to ground on this material. No? So ito second part ng general requirements sa grounding bonding sa 2.5. No? And of course, metal bar connected to the earth to limit induced voltage, lightning, and other high voltage charge, no? So, and of course this, no? So equipment grounding helps reduce fires in building as well as voltage stress on electrical insulation, thereby ensuring longer insulation life for motor, transformer, and other system component. So this is just a comparison. So I get it from Conwell. So this is from the direct hit of lightning, and see what will happen if you have protection here, no? So you have a lightning protection in your house, no? So it will go to the ground, no? Remember, lightning stroke is in microseconds, no? While your short circuit is in milliseconds. For indirect hit of lightning, you can see, no? So this one, so you have to go there, then also will go there and will go to the ground, no? So, and of course, indirect lightning stroke, no? So, nasa area pa rin. So, magpapasok pa rin sa system. So, it will pass to the system, to the tree. So, meron kasi dito to the ground, no? So, for the direct hit of lightning. So, this one, if you see, no? So if your line has no overhead static wire, no? So this will direct hit by lightning. So you need your overhead static wire so that to protect the line here from direct hit of lightning. From non-direct hit of lightning, you have to place a surge arrester. If you notice, all transformer as automatic surge arrester installed, no? To protect them from non-direct hit of lightning. So it should be, here in the Philippines, it shall be mandatory that all distribution lines shall have overhead static overhead light. Since we are located in an area, we are a prone area for lightning. So if you notice, Manila Electric Company, all their distribution system have overhead. No? So overhead guy wire or static wire to protect the line from direct hit of lightning. And of course, the code said mandatory that lightning rod or grounding should be brought to the customer side. No? If you notice the old system, they don't brought the grounding here in the customer. No? So right now it's mandatory in the electrical code, grounding for every meter should be brought to the residential to protect the house from lightning, no? So part of lightning protections. And of course, with new technology also, hopefully, we now have also SPD, no? Sub-protective device. Of course, to appreciate more for electrical practitioner, when you use sub-protective device or you put us for lightning protection, you should include a surge protection counter, no? Or maybe surge protection counter or lightning counter, so that you can see if number of lightning that hit your system for a purpose of monitoring. So this one is included in articles outdoor transformer, no? So you need here, system grounded building at here, no? Big problem here if there is no grounding here, no? If this no grounding and then this grounding become loose, the customer here will have suffer a high voltage, more than 1000 volt. So all his appliances, even its lighting switch is off, it will light because the voltage is more than 600 volt. So very important also to have one reason that you have a lightning here, no? Grounding here, no? So mandatory yan sa code, no? So grounding should be brought to the building. Of course, one good understanding also of the grounding and equipment grounding or also for lightning protections in the agriculture, no, agricultural building. Very important this grounding also for the farm, from the piggery, from cow, no? So the next, show you the grounding, the next slide, no? So equipotential bonding at agricultural building, very important here, no? I seen some animal, cause of death nila is due to electrocution. And of course, 4 to 5 volts potential difference, no? It will affect the productivity of the animal, no? So kung nagsuffering for electric siya for minimum of 4 to 5 volts, affected yung productivity of animals in the agricultural building. So very important this also in the agricultural building, the grounding and bonding and protection from overvoltage due to surge or lightning. In the swimming pool also, no? So this one, so equipment grounding, then a minimum of number 8, a solid at for bonding conductors. So many practitioners did not understand this. They don't put out the equipment grounding in the swimming pool, no? So that's why sometimes when you touch it, you suffer a certain shock, no? So this is the illustration of how we have equipment potential grounding in the swimming pool, even metal pens, no? So situate not no potential difference. So principle is equipotential bonding grid required. So that's also illustration. So you use minimum of eight copper, solid copper as bonding, no? So this one, so that there also no telephone, TV, electronics, especially the other profession like electronics engineering, they want to have their own grounding, no? So that they said if you don't have the own grounding, there will be noise, no? But for us electrical engineers, there should be an equipment grounding. What important is bonding. It's not allowed to have equipment grounding bonding for us because this is for safety. No? And if you notice in the Philippine Electrical Code, in the article objectionable current, noise is not considered objectionable current. No? So we can allow the electronic equipment, they have their own grounding. We call only it auxiliary grounding. But we cannot allow that our grounding will be not there. Mandatory. Because this grounding is for safety of property and people. No? Yung sa grounding ng electronics is only for sa electronics equipment, not those will have unnecessary noise. So very important here because it saves life and property, our grounding and bonding in this form. No? So this also, no, how you do bonding, no, so service entrance. So the same, no, all interconnected, the metallic part, it should be all interconnected and bonded. So to prevent potential difference. So equipotential principle. No, the same also. So you need all should be bonded together. So this for building, no? So, but the Conwell will introduce you to what is the latest technology, not all in a building managed lightning protection, not only using air terminal. So there's also innovation technology in lightning protection. So Conwell had this, what we call it, building management for surge protection, for lightning and surge protection. So hopefully they can introduce this. So you have a smart surge protection device, surge counter. Oops. So they have a surge counter, different from lightning counter, from direct hit. No? So then electromagnetic monitoring. Then they have an area lightning counter. No? So this will better give you analyze how many lightning strokes happen during the year, and you also know what months of frequency of lightning in your area. So with this new technology happening, we can now monitor. The difficult one is getting the data. So you need this counter, this lightning counter monitoring, because if you have now the data, you can easily analyze this, and also you can easily reset the management, how you protect the building because of this data. The data itself will speak. If you have no data, it's difficult for you to depend your expenses for lightning protection and surge protection. So this is it. And hopefully with this smart lightning management innovation at Conwell, we will be, for us practitioner here, will be more given more knowledge how to protect our building. So this one maybe will become part of your building management system. So especially if you have a multi-story building, so you might include smart lighting management in your BMS. So with that, thank you for listening.